We're going to be diving into the best Mac apps on the market for your daily productivity. These are going to be gems for boosting everything, including the likes of keyboard shortcuts and powerful ways to use and capture things across your day. These apps are all linked in description, and we're going to dive into, I think, about 12 or 13 of them. So let's dig in. So today's video is kindly sponsored by Craft. Craft is a Mac app that is a powerful way to create documents. It's got three features that I want to mention before this video. The first of those is a newly released feature called Tasks and Calendar. You can create daily notes and also manage your tasks all inside of Craft now. A great way to organize yourself with notes, calendar, and tasks in one. So they've also got an ability called Collections, which will allow you to organize any of your items into a database-like structure. This is a great way to organize all things that are items. And finally, page styling. Page styling is a great way to enhance all of the documents you share externally. If you want to impress people, this is the way to go. So you'll find Craft link in the description, and they'll be mentioned later in this video as they're one of the tools we picked as the best Mac apps. So let's dive into the full list, and starting with an app called Look Away. Now this one is an interesting one. What it does is helps you to improve your eye strain on Mac. So essentially what you do is install the app, and the app will track what you're doing in terms of your focus. And basically after 20 minutes, it will get you to look away from the Mac. And this will help you to better enhance your eye strain and reduce the need to remind yourself to actually get breaks in during the day. Now it works very smartly. It won't interrupt your meetings. It knows when you're in them, and it will do this automatically to make sure that you improve your focus and you also take those necessary breaks you need to across a day. So it's well worth considering if you're looking and you forget to take breaks across a day. Next up is another one called Lazy. Now, sadly, I haven't been given access to this yet. It's very much in a beta and a sort of public beta at that. And it's an app that will help you to capture a range of things. But I do have some amazing users and subscribers of this channel who are in the weeds with this app, and they find it a really great way to capture things, including everything from journal to people you interact with to sources that you collect, like articles and resources across your day. It works on Mac to help quickly capture that, and it's an interesting option, sort of like Superhuman combined with something like Readwise or Pocket, which are popular bookmarking reading type applications all in one house. I'll include any reviews of them below. So number three is Craft. Now, if you don't know Craft, it's a document-based application which will help you to manage all of your workload. It manages your tasks, your calendar, and also your notes in one location. But it's great for not just using as individuals, but also team members too. We use it at Toolfinder to manage all of our ideas, thoughts, and processes to bring together those ideas really fast. And it works rapidly on Mac. That's why I selected it in this video, and a big thanks to those guys for sponsoring. You can check out Craft below. So next one is Boom. This one is a Mac app that you can install to improve your next meeting. So it works in the background to allow you to customize the look of your meeting. Whether you're joining stuff like Zoom, Google Meets, WebEx, whatever it may be, it works to basically clean up what your camera looks like as you enter the meeting. Now it is free, but there are pro experiences, and this app is a really interesting one. It's sort of a layer to organizing how you look on camera. And if you're a freelancer, maybe even a busy professional, or just somebody that wants to deliver the best first impression when joining a meeting, then this could be something that you do. Sort of like when this video edited, it is sort of like a first impression. It's that brand element that you can add to it. So next up is Raycast. Now Raycast is gone incredibly popular over the last year, not only because they're adding AI features to help save you time, but because macOS Spotlight feature sucks. It honestly sucks. I try and search for it on it all the time, and it just is an untapped potential for Apple, really. If they don't update it in the next major macOS update, I don't know where they're going to be. But essentially, Raycast takes your Finder or your Spotlight experience and essentially upgrades it, adding things like clipboard so that you can basically paste and copy really easily, everything in terms of extensions, and a wide range of abilities that you can connect up. They even now have Raycast Notes, Raycast Focus in the premium to help you enhance how you're doing things. And I'm really eager to actually dive in, so I will tune back in when I've fully set up my Raycast, as it does take a little bit of time. So next up is Arc Browser. Now I get this several times a day. The browser experience is okay on Chrome, but a lot of people are hyping about Arc Browser. And although they're going through a little bit of a different change at the moment in terms of being an AI focused browser, the application still remains a free app for you to download and get started. There's even something called Arc Max, which has loads of AI features in it that are gonna save you small little bits of time across a day. Now, Arc Browser is the go-to and probably one of the best Mac ones. It's not for everyone. For example, I don't find it useful. I don't know, I've tried it. I've not really been sold by it, but I know so many people that love it and find it to go there as a Mac browser experience. So next up is Rise. Now this one, it has a Z in it. It is an application that helps track all of the work you're doing in the background and help you keep focused on task. It's a little bit like apps like Toggle Track that are popular for time tracking and then allowing you to see and analyze where you spent your time. But this one's slightly different. In the pro experience, you can have an assistant, like a accountability coach, where if you're visiting certain websites, it'll prompt you, you shouldn't be visiting them, and you should get back to work. This is a great way to stay on task, and a lot of people like this soft prompt to help you bring back into what you're doing, or what you should be doing. So next up is MimiStream. I think it's MimiStream or MimiStream, I don't know. The application is a Mac experience for Gmail. So essentially, imagine Gmail in its own Mac app that is beautiful. This app really looks gorgeous, and it is a download for Mac, which means it is separate from the web browser Gmail. And it only works with Gmail and Google Workspace naturally, but a lot of people like it because they get their own experience, and it sort of feels like if Apple Mail and Gmail had a baby and it was its own app, but Apple Mail sort of looks less attractive to this in comparison. So a lot of people are looking at it as their Gmail alternative for Mac. Next up is one called Granola AI. Now this one is an interesting one because people typically love AI meeting recordings, but this one's slightly different. Granola doesn't plug in with the app that you're using. So when you join a meeting, you don't have to awkwardly say, oh, my plugin AI meeting note taking app's here, and sort of have that weird conversation that's sort of like the new mute button of meetings. Essentially what this does is it works in the background. So you just have to say to somebody, oh, before we start, this is just being recorded in the background so that I can track all my notes. You can write your notes at the same time, and then it processes a transcript on top of your notes and turns them into valuable meetings. Afterwards, you can set up search, so you can actually communicate with your notes with a chatbot and search through them to find the relevant thing. So this one's an interesting one for Mac users. I think they give you free 20 meetings for trying out, and you can find it, like all these apps, in the link in the description. So the next one is IA Writer. Now it's not AI Writer, it's called IA Writer. It's been around for a while. It's a beautiful writing experience for your Mac. Now what it does differently is it goes into proper Zen mode. It's sort of like a typewriter type experience, but on your Mac. And it, I believe, is one-off on Mac. I'm not entirely sure on the prices, it does change, but I'll include the details to it in the link in the description. But essentially, IA Writer is beautiful. They even created their own notebook once, and it is beautiful. The application is really much more designed for writers, so if you're somebody typing away and you want a minimal, focused experience, it's probably better for you. Next up is Clean My Mac. If you've not got this, this one's run by the same company that run a Setapp, which is a subscription of apps that you can get as part of one subscription instead of paying loads of different costs. But a Clean My is an interesting way to clean your Mac up really fast. I use it probably every month just to gut my Mac and essentially get rid of large files, potentially scan for viruses and all the other stuff. You can get it as part of Setapp subscription, which I'll link below, but it's almost like my go-to one that I install every time I get a new Mac, which I hopefully is not as often these days. So our final two, and if you're interested in checking out all these apps, as I said, they'll be mentioned below. There is also a site that we run called toolfinder.co. You can go to it, choose a category for Mac and just narrow down your options. So there's even more Mac apps now. It's terrible. You're gonna have to find more space on your laptop. Hence why Clean My Mac might be a good option. So Super Whisper is an interesting one for Mac because what it does is it allows you to use hotkeys to essentially open up a AI speaking assistant. So for example, you can start dictating what you want to say really fast, like in an email, and it basically transcribes it for you and you can get it formatted instantly. This is great for people who are better at speaking faster than typing faster, me. but this app is great, even if you want to write articles or resources using this AI feature. So a good consideration if you're looking at those tools. So next and final one is called NotchNook. This one has been talked about so much. We actually did a full review on it down in the description below if you're interested. But NotchNook is a way to upgrade that notch experience on your Mac. It essentially allows you to add calendar, even tasks, music browsing, and also loads of other additional abilities. It is a one-time payment application, or you can get it as part of a subscription. But it's an interesting one if you want to turn that ugly notch into something useful. So thank you so much for stopping by, folks. A big thanks to Craft for sponsoring today's video. Hopefully these Mac apps helped you, to tickle your interest in the different Mac apps that are out there. But if you're interested in becoming a subscriber here on the channel, please do subscribe. And I'd love to have you over on toolfinder.co to explore more resources like this. Thanks so much, and I'll see you very soon. Cheerio.